Hello from Las Vegas. I'm in the guest bedroom of Dan Reynolds and Asia Volkman's house, where I'm staying for a few days before I leave for my European tour. Dan and I are writing songs together. We've been writing a song a day, which is very exciting. Dan, by the way, is the lead singer of Imagine Dragons, one of the biggest bands in the whole wide world. But he is also a dad of four kids, and a really, really good one. I would know, not only because he's my friend, but because I toured with Imagine Dragons for a year and got to watch him be a parent on the road. So today's episode is a conversation about fatherhood, what it means, and how you can be a rock star and a good dad at the same time. You know, one of the things that I've had the privilege of witnessing, because I toured with you for a year, was like really getting some insight into your family life and your role as a husband and the focus of this conversation as dad. And yeah, I just kind of wanted to just talk to you and pick your brain a little bit about what it's like to be a dad on tour, to be a musician dad, how that has changed. 2 weeks ago, you had another baby, you had your fourth kid. How do you think it impacts your music life and just you as a person, and what's like your philosophy, your approach?
I never talked about this before, actually. Yeah, I think first and foremost, I'd say my priorities as a human being are, especially when I'm on the road and I'm having to juggle, it's always number one, be a good dad. Number two would be put on a good show and try to fulfill my role as the singer of Imagine Dragons in the best way I know how. I think it's certainly impacted my music. It definitely impacts how I live on the road. But I actually find that I'm much happier on the road when I have my kids with me versus when I'm not. I've talked with some musicians who have told me, you know, I got tired of the road and then I had kids and then I wanted to get back on the road to be able to, you know, catch up on sleep. Yeah, get away and catch up on sleep.
I think you should do Harper.
No, I
don't
need
Harper.
Please.
She's
going
to
give
a boy to
I do feel like, because, you know, your wife is also a musician and has toured, it strikes me that has had to have influenced your parenting philosophy, because I see Arrow being a good listener, able to express herself, able to read emotional situations. And I think that's just really beautiful. Like, I think you're doing a really good job.
I don't feel like that all the time. I feel like, you know, it makes me happy though to hear that, because I think my biggest goal is for Arrow, one, to feel all my girls and my little boy to feel completely free to be themselves and express themselves. But I also think, you know, I've heard it from a lot of people growing up, where people were like, you should never be your child's best friend. You need to be their parent. You can't be both. And I'm like, actually, I really disagree with that. I think you absolutely can be their best friend and confidant and also their parent. It's super important to me that Arrow feels comfortable to tell me anything. And so I try really hard to just take everything in stride and to be their best friend, but also, you know, to say, hey, no, that wasn't cool, and let's talk about that. And why did we do that? You know, things like that. Like, I think you can be both.
Good dads are hard to find. Good dads are hard to find. Dad is a palindrome, so is mom. A lot of parents seem to get it wrong, yeah. Good dads are hard to find.
What's been your scariest moment as a dad?
For me, I never experienced fear, like harrowing fear, until I had children. And when they get hurt or you can't find your child, like I cannot explain the absolute horror that overcomes me, like just debilitating horror. I mean, there's just in the couple times where you're like, where's Arrow? And you can't find her, and you're looking, and you can't, like, that to me is like, I've never experienced horror like that. And so, yeah, I think, you know, the way that I would express it is, I love my kid, and maybe this is a bad thing, and people can debate over these things, but I'm just being honest. I find that I have an easier time loving my kids more than I have loving myself. And, you know, and that's something I'm working on, self-love. It's something I've always struggled with. But, for instance, if I'm in danger or something, sometimes I don't get that fear. I'm just not a very fearful person because of a fault that I have of not loving myself that much. So it's like, you know, I remember the first time I decided I need to go see a therapist and really seek serious help is when I was in like a plane, and the plane was like going down and everyone was freaking out. It was like this small little jet, and I was just like, eh, okay. Because I was really depressed at that time of my life. Yeah. And so as dark as that sounds, but the reason I explain that is because I never felt extreme horror until when your kid gets hurt or something, it's like my gut just like, ugh. And it's same with my wife, because I just, it's like a deep love. And look, I'm not saying it's good to not have that self-love. Like I should feel horror when my plane's going down. But, you know, that's something I'm working on. But yeah, so that just any time your kid is lost or, yeah, that's scary.
I think what you're describing, I've seen my parents go through, which is your children can be the catalyst for self-love. Because like you're seeing your ability to boundlessly love and accept these people. And I do think so much of love and care and family is about practice. It's just about doing it every day, being there, showing up, getting used to it. And I would imagine that for people who struggle to accept themselves or love themselves, parenthood could be a really powerful tool in that process if you're able to recognize it and like work on it.
I do think it's really important to recognize yourself and your kids and be like, I owe it to myself to love myself like that too. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, everyone out there,
love yourself.
Love yourself. Life's too short to be too hard on yourself. It really is. Even if you make mistakes. Well, if you make mistakes. Of course you're making mistakes. I'm making mistakes. Probably made a mistake 5 minutes ago. Okay, thank you, Dan.
Thanks, Flay. Love you. Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes, sir. Not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold. Have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
What I think is cool and potentially so expansive about being a good parent is that you get to practice these forms of acceptance and patience and compassion on a daily basis. And that those behaviors can seep into other parts of your life. And maybe, just maybe, they can even seep into the way you treat and love yourself. That insight at the end of our conversation has really stuck with me. It was like a big doink moment for my brain. So big shouts to Dan and all the rock star parents out there. No, you do not have to be in a band for you to qualify. You can have any job. You can be a butcher. You can be a medical supply salesperson. You can be a geometry teacher. Don't know why I'm now just listing jobs. Anyway, take care of yourselves. Take care of your kids if you got them. And I'll see you next week. If you want to talk to me about stuff on the internet, you can use the hashtag KFlayShow, or you can email me at thekflayshow@gmail.com. And of course, you can listen to my new album, Solutions, everywhere that you like to listen to music. So there's a new episode of What Am I Doing Here every week. Be sure to set a reminder for the K.Flay Show after 9 a.m. on Wednesday. I'm currently on tour in the UK and Europe, and I would love to see you. You can grab tickets at kflay.com/tour.